Greetings, folks. Joseph Kursky here, asking you, how walkable is your community? How walkable is your community? As you may have surmised from the many hundreds of videos I have on my channel, where I'm walking around urban and rural landscapes all over the world, I'm a very passionate walker. And I invite you to explore the new community walkability map that I created right here. Before we get into the map, though, let me ask you a few questions and get you thinking about a couple things. First of all, this is a new ArcGIS story map, and it also includes a button linked to a survey that I created with Survey123 from Esri. Plus, it has an operations dashboard that provides real-time information on what has been thus far recorded or collected on that map. The message I wish to convey through all of this, folks, is that through the creation of this resource, the combination of these connected tools, story mapping, ArcGIS Online, Survey123, operations dashboard, they're all part of the ArcGIS platform, and they offer amazing capabilities that are easily configured. Feel free to contribute to this, ideally along with a photo, in your own community or another place you have visited. As you do so, think about the kinds of things that you and your students, colleagues, stakeholders, friends, and even family in your communities could be collecting, mapping, and analyzing with these same tools. Water quality, graffiti or blight, weather, noise, albedo, types and amount of trash, cell phone signal strength, historical points of interest, tree height, tree species, tree condition, pedestrian or traffic counts, and much more. Start with these procedures presented as a story map. These procedures are online. They guide you through the process as they guided me in my creation of the story map that I'm going to show you right now. Here are a selection of photos that I have uploaded during some of my walks around the planet. And let's take a look at that story map on walkability. Here it is. I begin with a short statement. What is the walkability or pedestrian friendliness of your community? This streetscape happens to be in Mitchell, South Dakota, where I was for a GIS conference. Walkability, as I define it here, is the degree to which pedestrians feel safe and able to walk in their community. Whether one wants to walk in a community depends on many factors, right? Social norms, safety, personal preferences, and other factors. This study focuses on the physical challenges or lack of challenges that pedestrians face. For pedestrians using wheelchairs or pushing strollers, walkability can also be influenced by curb cuts, stairs, or obstacles on the sidewalk. What is the walkability on a street or path in your own community? Submit your own point using the link here. So in my story map, I have a point that I have the users click on, and what it does is it puts you on a Survey123. This is much like SurveyMonkey or Google Forms. You're basically dragging and dropping true-false, multiple choice, matching, Likert scale, etc., over to a web form. You can also use Excel for more power. But here, it's a very simple one. I say, is it pedestrian friendly or unfriendly? Rate the walkability. And also tick up all the choices here that describe the site. And where is the site located? Submit a photograph. Done. So that's my form. The results of the survey with data gathered from pedestrians all around the world can be visualized on this map right here. So if we scroll around on this map, we can see pedestrian friendliness or lack thereof in different places around the world. So you can see right here, here's a point that I took in Australia, and a beautiful spot and very pedestrian friendly. Ah, look at that. That's a secondary school where I was teaching, very pedestrian friendly, as many schools are, as well as the neighborhood. So that is a photograph that I took tied to this map at this location right there. I said pedestrian friendly, good for pedestrians, and it has a dedicated path or a sidewalk. Interesting. So you can scroll through on the map or with these attachments, and you can see another point that I took, and this one is over in Brisbane along a path along the river there. So here's another pedestrian friendly spot. You just have to make sure that you don't drift too far toward the river and go cascading down those rocks into the water. But beautiful and a very pedestrian friendly place. So those are two points that are tied to this map right here. Notice that I also used one of our customized base maps. Now these are wonderful because there's so many different kinds of base maps that you can use. This one's called Modern Antique. I really like this one. You can also customize your own base maps with your own colors, your own fonts. There's more documentation online about doing that. Fascinating to be able to do this. We're going to zoom in now to Mitchell, South Dakota, and so you can see the pedestrian friendliness of that community that I was showing you the photograph of earlier. Here are my points in Mitchell, South Dakota. Here is one of the photos that I took there, and this is from the famous Corn Palace. You can see the streetscape there, and then this one to the south a bit is the one that we looked at earlier. This was the one that actually I have at the start of my story map as the header. So a combination of story maps, ArcGIS Online, and then operations dashboard. Let's take a look at that operations dashboard for a moment. In the story map itself, I have a link to the map along with some text, a link to submitting your point, so gathering the points in the survey, and then I also have a link to the operations dashboard. This is a web mapping application that you can configure quite easily and decide what do you want to put in there. And you can see here that I've got a legend, I've got my interactive map, I have a gauge that tells me that 190 points thus far have been submitted to this map. I've got a couple of images here that show what this is all about. And I also have a couple of graphs in here saying, okay, most of these are pedestrian friendly, some are unfriendly, and then here's another graph from the data that I'm gathering that indicates those little tick boxes that people are checking, indicating a little bit more data about that. So that's an operations dashboard, and both the story map and the operations dashboard are easily configured from ArcGIS Online. So in this case, it's all about pedestrian friendliness, and you can read more about that in the GeoNet blog post essay of mine. The way that I created this is from these procedures right here, which is also actually a story map that you can see on this link here that tells you exactly how to do this just as I did. Quite easily done. Think about the possibilities in your own community to analyze patterns, relationships and trends, energy, water, natural hazards, population change, even right there in your community. So I encourage you to use these tools and especially use them in combination. That's what's so powerful about this. All of these things are actually done, as you can see, in combination because they're all part of this ArcGIS platform. All right, get out there and do some mapping. Thanks.